This is perhaps the most important video that I will ever make. Because this is life and death, and I'm sending out SOS in the name of all names, Isa Yeshua Jesus. Please, if you hear this message, please send it out, because this is urgent. This is extremely urgent, and it should matter to you, because I'm talking about the total oblivion of all of mankind. I've given the verses many times, but I've never read it, and I'm going to be reading it in this sitting. If not now, the next video or the next video. But I will give you the verses that I'm going to be discussing, and I'm no Chicken Little, and I'm not crazy. I believe something that nobody else in the world believes. What I believe is that this is infallible, and it is accurate, and it has foretold our future and the doom thereof if we interpret it correctly. And I don't know how anyone can misinterpret what it says. Praise God, the most important verses, the two most important verses in this Bible for the lives of all people on planet Earth. One is found in Matthew 24:22. The Lord says, unless these days, the age of grace, were cut short by His word anew, no flesh could be saved. There is nothing under the heavens that can cut time short except for the word of God. And I have proved that and will prove it many times again. No one can ever say that I'm off. So one thing is for sure, that's extremely important, that God's word gives us full disclosure to save us from the hour of our own annihilation, our own doom that would come in various ways. We are on a real slippery slope, and we're all going to sink or swim together. But praise God, that if you read Isaiah 60, our Lord Jesus Christ Almighty is the Son of Love arising with healing in His wings. And it's so important that people realize that He is all merciful. He would never allow the tribulation period just to swallow us up and consume us like a dirty old sponge, soaking up a bunch of garbage. He loves us much more than what most people believe. And I've had experiences. I am who I claim to be. So it's important and vital that we realize that these really are literally days as Noah. And people, if you believe the word of God, believe Zephaniah 1:1. Because Zephaniah 1:1 says that God will destroy man and all the birds and all the fish. I make that up not. But you have to realize when He says, I will destroy, all it means is He will let us destroy ourselves, because He has never destroyed any of us, not in the way that people have imagined. So it's time to rekindle the fires of restoration, of understanding. Isaiah 24 predicts our real fate would be the earth to rise never again in pieces, floating dead in space. Read it for yourself. Moses said one like him would come, and it was talking about physical death when Moses said, if you don't listen to the guy coming up next, the next revelator, because I am the end time revelator, line by line, precept by precept, with the strong and mighty one come forth as a destroying storm, pulling down distortional, looking through a glass darkly, understandings in favor for lifting up clear vision, clear sailing, clear understandings, nothing ambiguous anymore. Take it to the bank, absolutes. And so praise God. And Moses said that if you don't listen to the guy that's coming like me, there will be nothing but death ahead of you. And he was talking literal death, not spiritual death. And that's provable, because the Lord God has now given His kingdom age covenant through me. I am Elijah. And He's saying, I will be your God. You will be my people. I will forgive your iniquity. I will never remember it. I will write my law and my love upon your hearts. Beyond that, no one will ever need to even be taught of me, says the Lord God Almighty. Jeremiah 31, 33, and 35. And that is the message of Malachi 3:1 that prepares his way by his own word, by his own message, to cut time short. Only that can do it. And it is important and vital to people to get it into their brains that the most important for life on earth, the most important message in the whole entire Word of God is found in Jeremiah 30:24. It says, and I don't have to read it, it says, and read it for yourself, this will be considered in the latter days. I shall return my terrifying anger and stop the fast-rising great tribulation. Is God really angry at us? Yes, for our unloving ways. But is he really angry that he would kill us? No. Heck no, he loves us. But we are destroying ourselves, committing spiritual suicide. Believing in him has never meant squat. Many are going to say, Lord, Lord, I believed, I did this. And he's going to say, I don't know you. You let your love go out. He said, not I. He said that we must be as little children. So you know what? If your love is flowing passionately as a little child and you unconditionally love people around you and you're forgiving towards them because forgiveness is love, love is forgiving, then praise God, you're born again whatever you believe. And that is the absolute gospel truth. But people, don't miss the forest or the trees. This word of God has given one alarm that is ringing in the latter days. Why in the hell does anybody think I'm 6,700 videos as of today? It's February 3rd, 2022. And I've made 6,700 videos. Now, nobody is watching them. That's a whole different story. Because everybody is foretold that everything I would do would be in vain, Isaiah 49:4, until the Lord gets a hold of some hearts. And then within a time and half a time, all religion on earth will come with the shattering of the power of the holy people, Daniel 12:7, because the word was only closed until the time of the end, Daniel 12:9. And his word that cuts time short is his kingdom age covenant. Because he says, I will be your God, you will be my people. Paul said when that comes, all faith on earth would be obsolete. No one's paying any attention to anything I'm saying anyway. No one's believing any of the prophecy. People do not believe that these are days as Noah. There is no difference between me and Noah. Many years Noah labored in vain preparing an ark for a bunch of people that did not want no ride. And we have the absolute days of Noah right ahead of us, and nobody wants the ark that I have built. I've written scripture, new scripture, the everlasting gospel. I am the writer, the flying scroll. I am the writer, line by line, precept by precept, Isaiah 28, the strong and mighty one. I am that writer. I am the writer that was foretold by Moses, one like me, a kingdom age covenant giver, a writer even of the everlasting gospel, creation gospel. And not only that, but I am another Exodus leader that will lead the wheat out from the tares. They cannot grow together with his message of love. Because in the wording of the kingdom age covenant, Jeremiah is tearing down all imaginations, all kingdoms of man not built solely upon his unconditional love. Jeremiah 1:10, that is why I am as a destroying storm, because God always intended to pull down all distortionality so the wise may shine as the stars and no longer be looking through a glass darkly anymore. So it's time that we get with the real program of trying to save this earth, and we must all get along together because this world is foretold to be saved by his love being stirred up within us. And all these dreamers out there, people, no offense, I love blue heaven, I love you, lady, but they're all every day, people like the Moto X addict, every day, oh, the rapture's next week, oh, the rapture's next week, oh, there's never going to be a rapture. That is absolute truth. And I am Elijah, I have all authority. I am the alcoholic of Genesis 49:12, who comes forth with eyes red and dull of wine, and I hold the scepter of all authority according to that scripture. Listen to me! We got the imminent death of the whole friggin' planet! And no one wants to pay any damn attention to the guy that's sent to defuse the whole friggin'... Excuse me. I'm getting pissed off out here. People are so mamby-pamby and gotta kiss their ass and give them what they want to hear. I'm sorry, but the real message of love is transcendent and it goes beyond all that we have imagined. So praise the Lord. God has sent a way to make a salvation for all of us, our literal physical salvation. And there is much proof of this. Jesus said that unless these days were cut short by his word, no flesh could be saved. People, all of you opposing this channel are spitting in Christ's face because the message of Malachi 3:1 that prepares his way is his most passionate prayer that he ever prayed in the Garden of Gethsemane for our oneness. Is that a surprise? And that is why he will arise as the good shepherd over all the flocks of man. John 10, he foretold the unification. He took away our unification because we had many lessons to learn. And now he has joined us. And now he has given the name Chrislam to Israel. Because they have inherited all mankind, Isaiah 54:3. People, if you do not listen to me, if the hearts of the fathers don't turn to the children and the hearts of the children don't turn to the father, this world will face utter destruction, physical. Malachi 4:6, but guess what? There's an if in that word, if. And if there's a word that's if it's a little word, if, it is conditional. Just as Jonah 3, God told Jonah, go tell them they're going to be destroyed. They're going to be toast in 40 days. They were not. God relented. That's why God is saying, I will return my terrifying anger. This will be considered in the latter days. Don't you think that his messenger would give that message in the latter days? I am indisputably Elijah, and the whole world is spitting at me. And I have written the passage, Everlasting Gospel, Creation Gospel. It's here, several places in my huge mountain of videos. I have written the passion of Christ like no people have ever imagined. It's so passionate. And it's 48 half-hour videos. Scroll down. If you want passion with your faith, all faith is obsolete. No one is paying any attention to prophecy. Poo-poo, caca, fuck that shit. Well, fuck you too. Fuck you too. If you're going to be a dead brain, you're going to be a dead brain.